Joining me right now is former Department of Homeland Security's acting secretary, Chad Wolf. He is currently a visiting fellow at the Heritage Foundation. And Chad, it's good to see you again. Thanks very much for being here. Good morning to you.
Well, thank you for having me.
So many executive orders to go through with you and overturning of yours and President Trump's policies. Give us the significance of this legal win for Texas and Ken Paxton in your judgment.
Well, it's absolutely critical, and I'm glad the courts ruled on that. What we know from a halt in deportations is you are turning on the head the rule of law and immigration law. So if ICE and DHS can't do their job, can't remove individuals that have no legal right to remain in the U.S., then the whole nature of our immigration law is up in the air. And so it's the right ruling. Unfortunately, I would say that DHS has already decided to put further restrictions on who ICE law enforcement officers can and cannot deport. So even though the court ruling is a win, DHS has already given ICE instructions that they can only remove individuals in three specific classes. Those that come across the border, those that are aggravated felons, and those that are essentially terrorists, and which is very concerning. That takes off the board about 80 to maybe 90% of individuals they could legally remove out of the country. And so, again, just more concerning actions from the Biden administration.
Chad, the administration also halted the border wall construction, leaving high volume areas like the Rio Grande Valley quite vulnerable. We have a shot of the map here to show people where most of the people are coming in. I know that your colleagues have said it's 4,000 people at the border every day. What is the situation that the Border Patrol agents face on the ground? Walk us through this here.
Yeah, absolutely. The border wall system, and I've talked about it numerous times, it's not only that physical infrastructure, which people usually assume, that fence, but it's the lights, it's the cameras, it's the roads, it's the fiber optic sensors that gives Border Patrol agents the full picture there on the border. And so you mentioned RGV there in Texas. That is ground zero for illegal entries into the United States. And we had designated certain high priority areas for a border wall system. And now we know that the Biden administration has stopped all construction. So it puts a further strain on the men and women of the Border Patrol to do their job. And at the end of the day, what it means is you're going to see more and more individuals coming across those areas. You mentioned about 3,500 to 4,000 a day is who Border Patrol is picking up. That doesn't account for what we call the gotaways, which is another 15 to 20%
right,
of that numbers that, again, they just don't have the resources to pick up. So it's very concerning that you're going to take a tool off the table, out of the toolbox for our law enforcement officials.
Wow. So the 3,500 and 4,000 is at a minimum then. Let's take a short break, Chad. I want to get your reaction to the Biden White House blaming the Trump administration or the border crisis caused by their executive orders. We'll be right back with that. Stay with us with more from Chad Wolf.